contact. He also returns punts. He's projected around to be about a mid-round, a late-round guy, but he could go better. He's a guy that today has to show up.
Now, the Boilermakers will certainly have their hands full, and they're a bit short-handed today. For more on that, here's Eamon McEnany.
Well, Beth, you're absolutely right. It has been a fluid depth chart, to say the least, for Purdue as the Boilermakers come into this one undermanned just a bit. Leading rusher Ralph Bolden out with a knee injury. Leading tackler Dwayne Beckford, he's been suspended. Starting wide receiver O.J. Ross out due to academics. You can say the same for the leading punt returner, Wayne L. Gravesandy. So look for T.J. Barbarette and Josh Johnson to handle the punt returning duties. One positive note on the injury report, Beth, for the Boilermakers. Junior running back Akeem Shavers, good to go and will be in the starting lineup after missing the Indiana game with a concussion.
Thank you very much, Eamon. Purdue winning the toss. They elect to receive for head coach Danny Hope, now in his third season. And just last week, getting set to extend his Purdue career, close to signing a two-year contract extension. They are looking for their first winning season under Coach Hope. And Bill Cubitt in his seventh season. He's also their offensive coordinator. It's a high-flying offense. The last four games, averaging 50 points. They run 78 plays per game, Mike, and they like to snap the ball within 12 seconds.
I'll tell you what, they talk about 12 seconds if they don't substitute. And both the officials and the other team has to get used to that. They're only a very slow 18 seconds if they do substitute.
Purdue will receive, and they're awfully good at it. Number two in the country in kick returns at 27 yards per return. But Western Michigan, very good in coverage. They are third best in the country. And one of their best tacklers on special teams is also their kicker, John Potter, the senior from Grand Haven, Michigan. The Broncos in all white with the gold helmets, and the Boilermakers in all black. And into the end zone to Raheem Mostert, and he'll take a knee. And the Boilermakers will head out with their offensive unit, led by Caleb Turbush. He started out the fall as the third stringer, but he has settled in nicely as the starter.
He's a big physical quarterback that knows how to run this offense. He's an adequate runner, a very accurate thrower, completing over 60%. Doesn't make a lot of great plays, but doesn't make many mistakes, and that's why they have him in there.
12 touchdowns and 6 interceptions on the season. After Rob Henry was injured with an ACL and Robert Marv was slow to return from an injury, Turbush pressed into action early in the season, and he has held on to the job all year for the 6-6 Boilermakers. They will show a lot of different formations, traditional and non-traditional, moving their fullbacks and their tight ends and receivers around. Akeem Shavers gets the carry, the 5'11 junior from Texarkana, Texas.
Expect a lot of running game today from Purdue. They'll vary the tempo, but they want to keep the ball away from this very explosive Western Michigan offense.
They will go with a little wildcat, and Justin Sillers from Detroit will give it to Shavers, and a burst into the secondary, and inside the 40, shoved out of bounds at the Bronco 35 by Lewis Toler.
One of the things that Purdue has done very well this year is catch teams off guard by varying the tempo, going in and out of wildcat, giving the ball to various people. They've had a variety of running backs or wide receivers carry the football, and today Shavers has to carry the ball, has to carry the load for them on offense.
44 yards on the scamper. Turbush back in at quarterback under center. The give to Shavers. Ball pops loose at the 31-yard line. Looks like Purdue was able to corral it after a big hit from Aaron Winchester, their starting safety, who is their converted running back and one of the hardest hitters on the team.
And they said he's all of 5'5", maybe standing out of phone book, but a tough son of a gun that plays both ways. Even now, I saw him last game, he played running back for a couple plays.
He picked up a couple on the play, 2nd and 8. Out of the shotgun, another different formation for Purdue. They'll send Edison in motion, and he'll get the ball, and he will lose a yard. Good tackle by Trevante Bowles. Johnny Simon also in pursuit. Well, offensively for Purdue, Shavers getting his third start, replacing the injured Ralph Bolden, and Justin Siller hoping to have a big game back home in Detroit. Huge offensive tackles. Dennis Kelly at 6'8", Trevor Foy at 6'7". They'll try and take advantage of their perimeter size and a flag.
Offense, walking the helmet for 12 people. 5-yard penalty, third down.
Unfortunately, they had 12 men in the huddle, figured out once they had already broken, which is an automatic penalty. One of the things with so many personnel groups running people in and out, you've got to have somebody on the sideline that signals the group so everybody can see it. So, you know, I'm in that group. Sometimes with a new player, Shavers hasn't been in all these groups. He's taken Bolden's place. It may have been him. You don't know who was not supposed to be there.
Jared Crank offset in the backfield. Four receivers on third and 14. Turbush looking to go deep. Bush, the intended receiver at the five, incomplete. And the coverage by Donald Seliskar, the true freshman from Winter Haven, Florida.
There was a lot of contact going down the field. They were sort of both leaning on each other, and I think the thing is, it's sort of a mutual locking arms right there. And I know that Gary Bush wanted that call. He said, hey, come on. He had my arm, the arm bar.
Well, Carson Wiggs, who is their field goal kicker, is also their pooch punter. And he will try and bury this one on fourth down. Jordan White is the punt return man. Fair catch will let it go over his head. And the Boilermakers able to keep that out of the end zone and down inside the 1 yard line.
Great job, two things. The punter kicked the ball end over end, and then the team gets down there and watch. Doesn't matter where the guy is. Uh-oh, that ball's in the end zone. That's going to be a touchback. Unless he downed it, let's take a look and see. If he got it down and had control, right there as he sets it down. No, it rolled on his foot. I'm going to tell you what, I think they're going to review that. They're going to need to review that because that ball, if the ball breaks the play.
The touchback because the ball was possessing the field of play.
There they go.
Previous play is under further review.
Well, he just said it was ruled a touchback, but they have put the ball down inside the 1 yard line.
Yeah, I believe it will be a touchback. Basically, it is where the ball is. It is not where the man is. So the man can stand anywhere, but the invisible line that goes up from the goal line, if the ball breaks that plane, it's a touchback. If it does not, if it was down, he had to have control, though, to down that football. And as he put it down, actually hit his foot, I think you watch it. It's a great angle right here to see. Hit his foot and then kicked it, rolled back and crossed that line. I think the review will probably show that it was, in fact, a touchback.
Regardless, a terrific punt by Carson Wiggs.
After further review, the ball broke the plane of the goal line, therefore it's a touchback.
Now to the 20-yard line for Western Michigan and their first possession. And offensively for the Broncos, it's a potent group. The wide receivers are the ones to watch. The three guys there have combined for 28 touchdowns, and they're all fifth and sixth year guys, a lot of good experience. The O-line is all about pass protection. Kevin Gallagher, the center, is the leader. He will also be playing across the line of scrimmage from his former high school teammate, Bruce Gaston. And both quarterbacks are in the game for the Broncos.
This could be
down.
A double pass.
It's caught by White out across the 40-yard line. Another flag at the end of the play. So flags bracketing that play on the tackle by Ricardo Allen and a pickup of 21 yards.
And you can see this is a lateral throwback from the quarterback to quarterback, actually. And both teams talked about being ready for tricks. They wanted to get an idea. And the defense, it's really hard because these teams in spread formations and ever-changing formations, you really don't know who's in the game sometimes.
Both Alex Carter and Tyler Van Tubergen, their starter and their second stringer, were on the field.
A little shift on the offense, the wide receiver. Personal foul, face mask, number 21 defense. Those penalties all set. Replay, first down.
See if we can take a look. If everybody gets set for one full count or moves a little bit. And as you can see, the receiver at the bottom of your screen was moving prior to the ball being snapped.
Caleb Ravenel, and there's a face mask and a rough way for Jordan White to get hauled down.
That hurt. That'll stretch your neck a little bit the wrong way.
Jordan White, the sixth-year guy from Cleveland, Ohio, second-team All-American. Alex Carter's favorite target. He's responsible for over 40% of the team's completions this year. Carter with time to Ravenel, couldn't hang on. Ruled incomplete.
And that doesn't happen very often because Ravenel, the JC transfer, is one of the other go-to guys that takes some of the pressure off of White. But one thing about Carter, he can make all the throws. He does a great job of reading defenses, too, which allows him, even the spread formation, to know where to go with the ball.
Carter, they show that five-wide look, and the pass caught underneath Eric Monette. Down the sideline, bumped out by Joe Holland, and a first down pickup, 20 yards on the game.
Eric Monette and Josh Schaefer, 82 and 86, are not the all-star guys, but they're the guys that Coach talked about really coming through this year in this five-wide receiver set and taking the pressure off of White.
They like to try and snap the ball within 12 seconds. About 20 seconds before they got that one away. And the pass deep across the middle. Ravenel again, unable to haul that one in. Second and 10 coming up. For Purdue defensively, Kawan Short is an all Big Ten performer right in the heart of that defense. 14th in the country with 17 tackles for loss. A junior out of East Chicago. Chris Carlino will get the start in the middle for the suspended leading tackler, Dwayne Beckford. And again, quick on the snap. And the handoff to Wallace. He's tripped up as he got tangled up with his quarterback. The secondary, Allen and Johnson. Well, they've had their hands full with a couple of top receivers in the country this year. Michael Floyd at Notre Dame, A.J. Jenkins at Illinois, and now a shot at the All-American Jordan White today.
And it's not just White, it's that entire cadre of wide receivers that spreads you out and cause you to be in much more single covers than they want.
On third and 15. Clock winding down to five. Carter short, trying to bring some pressure up the middle. Carter gets away from it. And trying to climb the ladder to bring it in at the 45. Incomplete.
Unusual to have this many drops in the game. And I'm tell you what, this is a great job of just putting it up there. This guy goes up, makes Arnon. That's a great play. Just can't quite hang on to it. He's a long ways above the ground, knowing if I hang on to that ball, that my back is going to take the brunt of that when I hit the ground.
Ben Armour back to kick. Sometimes it's an issue for teams, Mike, when they come into a dome and all of the space that Western Michigan may not be accustomed to, and the possibility of some trouble to pick up the ball in flight.
Beth, you're absolutely right. A lot of times you see the ceiling, because there is a ceiling as opposed to the sky. As you look up, sometimes you see the ceiling instead of the football.
Purdue and Western Michigan scoreless. Beats the alternative of spitting rain and snowfall outside in Detroit.
We're proud to sponsor the Little Caesars Pizza Bowl. And proud that from Little Caesars, you get the best value in America. And you get a great pizza. Here are some facts you may not know. Our tomatoes are picked at the peak of flavor and go fresh from the farm into our sauce. Our cheese is 100% real. And our dough is made fresh from scratch each day in every store. The bottom line, you get a better quality pizza for less at Little Caesars. Try it and see for yourself.
Pizza, pizza.
Yeah, I'm married. Doesn't matter. You do that for me? Really? Yeah, I'd like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's Jake from State Farm. Sounds like a really good deal.
Jake from State Farm at 3 in the morning? Who is this?
It's Jake from State Farm.
What are you wearing, Jake from State Farm?
Khakis.
She sounds hideous.
Well, she's a guy, so.
Another reason more people stay with State Farm. Get to a better state.
It's your social network, all mixed together. With Galaxy Nexus by Samsung, now you can organize your contacts into circles, like you do in real life. So you can choose what people see and what they don't. And with the speed of Verizon 4G LTE, you can chat as a group in a Google Plus Hangout without missing a beat. Introducing the first phone built for Android 4.0, only at Verizon.
Tigers, tied. One night to decide it all. The Allstate BCS National Championship Game. LSU, Alabama. Coverage begins January 9th at 8 on ESPN.
Tony, pick it up.
I'm just not feeling the wood-cutting thing today.
Tony, eat a Snickers.
Why?
Because you get a little bit whiny when you're hungry.
Better?
Better.
You're not you when you're hungry.
Hey! My back hurts!
Snickers satisfies.
Now my front hurts.
Toshiba ushers in the next era with its powerful new Portage Ultrabook. It's engineering you can barely feel, but will certainly notice. Learn more at us.toshiba.com.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
Well, not quite baseball weather outside here in Detroit. Across the street from Comerica Park. It was a good year for the Tigers, a terrific year so far for the Lions. Pleasant inside at 68 degrees today for Western Michigan and Purdue. Here at Ford Field, home of the Lions, who are headed to the playoffs for the first time since 1999. And the second time out here for the Purdue offense, Akeem Shavers in a tailback. Turbush out of the gun will send Shavers in motion. Now throw the bubble screen. Bush all down at the 44-yard line. Short gain. The Western Michigan defense features Drew Nowak on the inside. The MAC Player of the Year, big Reggie White fan growing up in Green Bay. Their linebackers, Mitch Zajac playing in his 50th career game today. That ties a school record. Siller in the Wildcat. And the Detroit native across midfield. He'll pick up the first down for Purdue. Finishing up that Western Michigan defense, it's a young secondary. Two true freshmen, a sophomore, and a senior who is a converted running back in Aaron Winchester, but he may be the toughest guy on the team.
And they like Seliskar a lot. You take about a long, lanky, fast corner. That's what you want for cover.
Turbush back in a quarterback. The handoff to Shavers. They continue to work their ground game. They don't want to give that Western Michigan offense a whole lot of time on the field today.
They think they have an advantage at the line of scrimmage. They also want to dominate time of possession, as we talked about, to keep the ball away from Western Michigan. But they really believe that they can run the football. They've been a good running team all year long.
There, without their starter Ralph Bolden, an ACL injury. Shavers didn't play the last game with concussion-like symptoms. And he's doing a nice job for them early here in the first quarter. Picks up a couple more to set up a third and five. Johnny Simon, the leading tackler for Western Michigan, had the stop.
Western Michigan has not been a great defense. They've been a great defense on fourth down and in the red zone. But in between, they've given up quite a bit of yardage.
Here's another one of those non-traditional looks. They'll bunch three receivers to the top of the screen. Turbush looking away from them, trying to get away from the rush. It's knocked loose. Ball on the deck. And the Broncos have the first turnover of the day, forced by Paul Hazel and recovered by Mitch Zajac.
What happens sometimes as a quarterback is you get a sense of the pocket, you start to panic a little bit. He started to think, I better run. He dropped the ball down. Now you got to put it away. He thought, maybe I can throw it. Too late. You got to protect that football. When you get inside there among the Giants, you got to protect the ball.
And not only that, but when Hazel tackled Turbush, Caleb could not break his fall and comes off injured.
And Hazel is one of their best pure passers. He's angular, 6'5", 210, but all he does is rush the passer.
Back to work for Alex Carter in this Bronco offense. The pitch back to the quarterback. Looking deep down the middle. He's got White behind the defense. Touchdown, Broncos! 49 yards to the All-American. And for the first time in school history, Western Michigan leads in a bowl game.
Two first down opportunities, two trick plays. With both of them, probably should have worked other than the penalty. But I'll tell you what, I was impressed with Jordan White's speed on that. Once he got going, he left the defenders in the dust. Perfectly thrown pass off the flea flicker.
Extra point, the fake, and in for the Broncos. They're pulling out all the stops. Their motto the last few weeks has been chasing history. They want the first bowl win the Broncos have ever recorded.
I think you should say making history. Here's the flea flicker. Watch this throw. And again, this hits the receiver right on strike. Jordan White, first strike. But watch this extra point. Here you go. You can see easy. They've struck first. They want to strike many times.
In honor of the Pizza Bowl, Little Caesars is shaking things up. Today through December 29th only, when you buy any hot and ready pizza, we'll give you a free 8-piece order of crazy bread. Just visit LittleCaesars.com. Download the coupon. Buy any hot and ready pizza, and you'll get a free 8-piece order of crazy bread. Shake up your dinner tonight at Little Caesars. Pizza,
pizza. Capital One's new cash rewards card gives you a 50% annual bonus, so you earn 50% more cash. According to research, everybody likes more cash. Well, almost everybody. Would you like 50% more cash?
No.
But it's more money.
The new Capital One Cash Rewards Card. The card for people who want 50% more cash.
What's in your wallet? Whoa! What's up, guys?
Hey, man, it's not a Miller Lite. What's the big deal?
Miller Lite has more taste.
Strike two. One more, you lose your man card.
Wait, what was strike one?
Hey, I'm running low on pizza.
Wait, but how did you guys get your beef?
We bought them.
Man up and choose Miller Lite. We add hops not once, not twice, but three times. Brewed for that great Pilsner taste.
Whoa. She must have paid a fortune.
Just a tank full of gas away, there's an ocean that wants you to hear its roar. A river ready to take you on an adventure. Or a lake waiting to share its serenity. To get you there and back, there's us, with quality gasoline and all the food and drinks you need to get you where you want to be. America, beautiful in so many different ways.
ESPN College Football, the Little Caesars Bowl, is brought to you by Little Caesars Pizza, home of the large hot and ready pizza, always fresh out of the oven, ready when you are. The Ford F-150, available with the efficiency and power of EcoBoost. And the new Capital One Cash Card, for people who want 50% more cash.
Happy holidays from Detroit, Michigan in the Little Caesars Bowl at Western Michigan. A 49-yard touchdown pass following the turnover. Alex Carter to All-American Jordan White in the first bowl lead in Bronco history. And now how will they protect it? There's a possibility, too, of a quarterback change coming up for Purdue as starter Caleb Turbush was dinged up when he fumbled the football on the sack. The kickoff, Raheem Mostert in the end zone for the Boilermakers, and this time he's going to bring it out. Mostert, good numbers this year on kick returns out to the 24-yard line and tackled by the kicker, John Potter. Let's go down to Eamon McEnany.
Well, Beth, Caleb Turbush didn't have a whole lot of time to get ready to go back out there with the training staff. They took a look at the range of motion on his left arm, tested his arm strength. He even warmed up. He has his helmet on and looks like he's ready to go back out there, but they're going with Robert Marv instead on this series.
Marv, the fifth-year senior out of Tampa, a bit of a stronger arm coming back from an early season injury, played in 9 games this year.
And that may be according to plan. They like Robert Marv. He's the healthiest he has been and has a very live arm and is actually faster than Turbush.
For much of the season, he has come in for a few possessions in the second quarter. A handoff to Shavers. The highlight certainly for Robert Marv and perhaps for this Purdue team this year was their comeback win against Ohio State. He scored the game winner in overtime.
A lot of people think Purdue, what kind of team? 4-4 and a win over Ohio State in the Big Ten Conference is a very good football team. This team can play well, but they have to be balanced. They're going to run the football first. It takes patience, so to run the ball when you're behind.
Shavers behind Jared Crank in the eye. Caught by Siller. First down and out across the 35. Tackle made by Lewis Toler. Justin Siller, the fifth-year senior from St. Mary's High School here in Detroit.
One of the things that Marv can do because of his speed is get to the outside. That was a designed rollout where it's a run-pass option. At some point, the DB looked at him. That allowed the receiver to get open.
First and 10, Purdue. Another non-traditional look. They give to Shavers running away from the motion. And he'll go to the side, pick up about 8. Second and short. Freddie Bishop on the tackle. As Capital One Bowl Week continues, a couple of games on Wednesday. It's Toledo and Air Force in the Military Bowl presented by Northrop Grumman. And then Texas and Cal in the Bridgepoint Education Holiday Bowl. Capital One Bowl Week on ESPN, ESPN3, and then also streaming live on the Watch ESPN app. Second and a couple. Shavers will take it, get across midfield, and pick up another first down to the 45. Trevor Ishmael with the tackle.
And sometimes you have student body right, sometimes student body left. That was student body middle. They had a lot of folks leading up inside. And I tell you what, Shavers, we talked about, is going to have to carry the mail today.
8 carries for 72 yards. His season best was a 75-yard, 2-touchdown performance against Southeast Missouri early in the season. On the run, Maher diving to get out of bounds away from the oncoming traffic. Ishmael got there first.
One of the issues with the zone read is when you get instant penetration at the mesh point, it disturbs the quarterback. Now he's got to take it and run. And he discretion the better part of valor. I think he worried about getting hit on those knees. Did a great job of trying to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Reggie Pegram now in the backfield. Marv, play action. To Pegram, wide open out of the backfield. Inside the 35, the cut. And a first down. Pickup of 18 on the play. Well, of note this year for Purdue, the third year in a row they have beaten a ranked opponent. They took down Illinois. That huge win against Ohio State in overtime, and then the one that got them bowl eligible in their regular season finale, getting them into a bowl and also getting them the bucket in the win over Indiana. Wildcat again with Siller. And Justin will keep it. Get anywhere. May have lost one on the play, second and 11.
And those three big wins you talked about might have gotten Danny Hope that 2-year contract extension that he has agreed to. One of the things, too, about that is from a recruiting standpoint, you always want to be at least 4 years hired in advance so that you can talk about anybody I'm recruiting, I'll be there your entire time.
They would certainly love to lock down this game as well because it would give them a winning season. They come in here at 6-6. They have had 3 consecutive losing seasons at Purdue. They got to 500 in the Big Ten Conference this year. Always nice to be able to go out recruiting after the winning season. And Simon with the bull rush, the linebacker, and the big sack.
Simon very active coming off that edge, but that is on the quarterback. That's on Robert Marv. He's got to see that second rusher coming off the edge. He's got a guy in the flat right now that is a safety valve. He's got to get his eyes downfield. When he feels that pressure, can't keep the ball. Can't take that kind of sack.
Loss of 14 yards, and now it's third and 25 for Robert Marv, who's on here in relief of the injured Caleb Turbush. Trying to get away from Hazel. And along with it, he will get back to the original line of scrimmage. That's it. You go for it here, and you go with one of the top kickers in the country. And it looks like they're going to kick this one, Carson Wiggs.
Yeah, I think you get points on the board. I think you're down, you know, 8 points. You cut it to 5, like a baseball score, or whatever the case may be. But get some points on the board. You know, you never know. We talk about fakes all the time, and this is a fake area of the field.
45-yarder for Carson Wiggs, who has hit 9 in a row, including 4 in the season finale in the win against Indiana. And he missed it. The streak comes to an end for Carson Wiggs. And the 45-yarder is no good. Purdue comes up empty, and Western Michigan maintains the 8-0 lead. Broncos seeking their first bowl win. They're on top here in the first.
The Tostitos Fiesta Bowl, Stanford, Oklahoma State, Monday on ESPN.
It's so nice to spend time just you and me.
I know. This is great.
No, I feel like... Did you just check the game on your phone?
What? No. What am I, like some kind of summoner who can just summon footage to his phone like that? Come on.
I guess I'm just a little oversensitive. It's just that you and
yes.
Only AT&T's network lets your iPhone download 3 times faster. AT&T.
There was a little bit of trepidation, not quite knowing what the next phase was going to be, you know, because you've been, you know, this is what you've been doing, you know, working. And now you're talking about, well, you know, I won't be, and I get the chance to spend more time with my wife and my kids. It's my world. That's my world.
Red Solo Cup, the latest good time hit from country superstar Toby Keith.
Let's have a party. I love you, Red Solo Cup.
Look for Red Solo Cup off of Toby's new album, Clancy's Tavern.
Proceed to party. Proceed to party.
Toby Keith, Clancy's Tavern features Red Solo Cup and the number one hit, Made in America. Available at all Target stores.
Okay. So what kind of car do I want? It has to be an SUV. Definitely silver, new or used.
Now compare new and used cars, and even special offers side by side.
Gotta be new.
So when you find the right car, you'll know it in your heart.
Sweet.
Autotrader.com, the ultimate automotive marketplace.
Back here at Ford Field, 8-0, Western Michigan scoring off of a turnover and then a little trick play on the PAT. Took it in for two. Alex Carter off the punt fake, looking to go deep again for Ravenel, through his hands, incomplete. Romando Harris on the coverage.
And they're not comfortable just dink and dunking and throw those quick little screens to the outside. I mean, they're going deep all the time, which is going to keep the Purdue secondary on their heels a little bit, but they're getting rid of the ball early so they don't put too much pressure on the offensive line.
Scriven into the backfield, where he's joined by Brian Fields. Carter deep across the middle, looking for White, popped up in the air, incomplete. Joe Holland, the linebacker, that time had the coverage. What's the biggest challenge, Mike, with the five wideout look all the time and the pressure they put on that defense?
Well, you immediately have to cover the width and breadth of the field. And the problem is, if you're in zone, there's too many people to cover a zone. If you're in man-to-man, you can clear out, let one guy work underneath. So you have to do sort of a matchup zone or some combination coverages that keep people at home.
Schaefer and Monette come on, so back to the five wide. Carter deep down the middle, and this one's intercepted. Picked up by Albert Evans. And Evans will take it back inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. The intended receiver that time didn't have his head back trying to locate the ball.
Well, and this was only a three-man rush, which allowed them to drop 8 in coverage. The free safety does a great job of just reading the quarterback's eyes. You see the three-man rush right there. You got a spy player underneath, but free safety just broke on that ball better than the receiver. I'm not sure the receiver knew that the ball was coming to him. Couldn't quite find it. Great job, though, of covering the field. That's what a free safety does. Play center field, play the middle, and then read the quarterback's eyes.
Second pick of the season for Albert Evans. Western Michigan scored off of a turnover. Let's see if Purdue can convert. Robert Marv will stay in at quarterback. Rolling to his right, looking for a block. And takes it out of the 40-yard line.
You know, we've seen Robert Marv earlier this year. They talked about him being the best shape he's been in, and he's more comfortable now running and taking or initiating contact with the defense.
Well, one of the things that we picked up on watching Purdue a couple of times this year, you've seen the tendency for Marv to constantly leak out to his right, sometimes away from his protection.
There's a comfort zone in that. He panicked, rode over the top. But once he does that, he has no chance to have help from the offensive line. So he's got to make the play, and at that point, nobody could get open.
A transfer from Miami, former high school Florida Mr. Football. Healthy finally for the first time for the Boilermakers. He dumps it off into the flat. A couple yards shy of the marker. Lewis Toler, the sophomore out of Newcastle, Delaware, with the tackle, it'll be third and short.
That was actually, too, there's great protection and great coverage. Marv had a lot of time to sit in the pocket, survey the field, finally flushed to his right and got the receiver to come back to the ball, what we call a scramble plan. So you have to have, when the quarterback scrambles, everybody's got a plan on what they should do. Come back to the ball, find a way to get yourself open.
Well, you can see Caleb Turbush is chomping at the bit for an opportunity to get back in there. Was injured on a fumble earlier in the game. Marv has since come on. Siller, the motion man. They're in danger of letting the play clock run out, or did they get the timeout in time? Yeah, they did.
Timeout, Purdue. This is the first charge timeout of the first half. Timeout.
We'll take the quick timeout here with Western Michigan in front. 3 minutes to go in the first.
That's one small step for man. One giant leap for mankind.
They come from all over, from north and south, from the Midwest and the Far East. They come to study, to learn the ropes, to graduate with honors, with tools that will serve them in life. Because it was here that we learned what was, what is, and what could be. Western Michigan University. Grab the reins.
Purdue forced to call the timeout with the play clock winding down. 3 minutes to go here in the first on a third down play from the Western Michigan 31. Marvel gives to Shavers, finds room up the middle, and he's got the first down inside the 30-yard line. Following behind James Shepard, Rick Schmig, and Nick Mundick.
Third and three is an either or down, but the reality today with the advantage I think that Purdue feels they have at the line of scrimmage, they're probably going to run the ball very many times in that situation. I know the coaches were not very happy about having to burn that 20, that timeout, though. You've got to know as quarterbacks in the new stadium, where's the 25 or 40 second clock? You've got to be able to see it and visualize it, or somebody else on the field, another receiver has to do that too.
It's a Bronco defense that has struggled against the rush this year, allowing about 215 yards per game. Marv to the air, floats one up, and incomplete. Gary Bush could not locate it.
One of the difficulties being an inside receiver running to the corner of the field, there's a blank spot. When you make your cut, you can't see back over the top of your head, and if the ball's thrown at the wrong time, you never find it. You can never track the trajectory.
We'll get our one Tim Tebow allotment out of the way right now, and we'll mention that Robert Marv followed in Tebow's footsteps in Florida high school and actually broke some of Tim's passing records before he moved on to college. And now Tebow, of course, getting a lot of attention with the Broncos. Has to dive on a loose ball after the snap.
I'm not sure. I recruited Tim out of high school. His passing, I'm not sure the records were all that great, but the combination dual athlete that he was, the threat to run the ball, he threw the ball like a cannon. It just, he wound up and fired. The same ball went 10 yards, 40 yards. I mean, it was about 10 feet off the ground. But Marv is probably actually a better pure passer in some regards than Tebow.
They really like his live arm, Gary North called it, the energy that he brings. Purdue one of four on third down today. Turbush with the pressure coming. Passes away. Catch made by Edison inside the 10.
And Edison is the guy they really want to go to. He's the most explosive player on the field other than Shavers, but especially of all the receivers. This is a tremendous job in terms of focus. One guy goes up and just comes off his hands, reaching back. I mean, that is hard to do. I don't think anybody can understand that, changing your body angle to get back to the ball.
That was a ricochet off of the DB's helmet. 21 games in a row now, a catch for Edison. And again, to Pegram, who dives down to the two. Look at this
one
ricochet.
More time. Yeah, absolutely. Pin it against the helmet, clasp it, bring it over the top to me. That's my football.
That was Aaron Winchester's helmet that will get the assist there. Terrific catch by Edison. Keegan, right up the middle, stuffed. Good push at the line of scrimmage. Led by Winchester and Rontavious Atkins, getting some help from their safeties on that run.
Yeah, there wasn't a lot of mystery about that play. That was power O. That went exactly where the defense thought it would, right out, right to the tight end. They had 10 guys, 9 guys at least, coming rallying to that football. Watch out for the play action now because of that.
Shavers returns after getting some attention from the training staff on the sideline. He's the deep back in the eye. Marv to the air. Pegram makes the catch. Touchdown.
Now, the interesting thing, the common thought here would just be to kick it. Redmond would try to go for two to tie it up. In the second half, you would go for two. In the first half, typically, you go for one, but you never want a bowl game. There are no rules.
Good catch by Pegram. His first touchdown of the season. The sophomore from Terrell, Texas, and Robert Marv with the touchdown throw, his fourth of the year. Carson Woods on for the extra point. The punter, Cody Webster, is the holder. And after the missed field goal, Woods comes back and gets the PAT in an 8-7 game.
I want to go back one more time and take a look at that catch by Edison, because this is something, guys, you don't see every day. One guy touches it barely. He pins it against the back of his helmet with one hand, controls the ball, and cradles it in. And I'm going to tell you what, unbelievable. We talked about the play-action potential down here. Marv does a nice job. You see Pegram in the flat. He releases under and makes really a very, very nice catch for a guy who hasn't had that many receptions this year.
Both teams scoring touchdowns off of turnovers here in the first quarter. Well, hey, fans, with ESPN's new football game, you are the most explosive player on the field, the return man. Hit the gap, break tackles, and take it to the house. You can play for free at ESPNReturnMan.com. Western Michigan, aided by the fumble, scoring in the first quarter, and Purdue using the interception to set themselves up for the Reggie Pegram touchdown catch. Boilermakers were here in Detroit in 2007. They beat Central Michigan in a shootout, 51-48, in what was then called the Motor City Bowl. And now another MAC opponent. One of just 4 games this bowl season that has a BCS team and a non-BCS team going head-to-head.
Well, Western Michigan, as we know, can score some points. So, you know, don't get too happy if you're ahead a little or just behind a little.
Oh, they attempt the onside kick that trickles right across the 40-yard line, and a big break for Purdue as they caught the Broncos unaware.
That was supposed to be a pop kick, the type that you use for the onside kick at the end of a game. But the kicker actually mishit it. You watch the ball comes off the side of his foot. And right there, it's got to go 10 yards. As soon as it crosses that mark, then it's live ball. The receiving team can go get it at any time. You can see right there, nice job. Just a lot of luck. That's the bounce of the ball.
It was so bad, it was good. Let's go down to Amon.
Offense coordinator Gary Nord had confidence in the special teams, because right after the touchdown, he called Caleb Turbush, you're up next, get ready, warm up. We're going to get the ball back quickly. So obviously number 19 now after the touchdown, back out there, but it looks like he's going to line up as a wide receiver.
Turbush will line up at wide out to the bottom of the screen. Siller is in the Wildcat again. The give to Shavers. And Shavers head over heels. Seliskar able to trip him up. And oh, that's a...
Did you notice on that play, though, Caleb Turbush is the lead blocker at the point of attack. I'm not sure they planned on that one.
With a bit of a bum shoulder. He doesn't get dinged up. We've played one at an 8-7 lead for Western Michigan.
Of the world. So listen up. Ford F-150 was just named Motor Trend's 2012 Truck of the Year. Know why? Well, here's your lesson of the day, pal. It's all in the name. Motor Trend. See, the Ford F-150 is the only truck out there with EcoBoost, which is a powerful motor that also delivers on the trend of excellent gas mileage. Got it? It's Truck of the Year 101, baby. Class dismissed. This is the future. This is the Ford F-150.
I shop on my laptop. I book flights on my tablet. I bank on my phone. I have Kaspersky One on all my devices, so I know I'm always safe.
Introducing Kaspersky One Universal Security. All you need is one.
I'm a streaker. I'm 300 pounds, painted blue, and apart from the cleats, I'm completely naked.
And if you've got 15-minute insurance, they might not pay for this. So get Allstate. Mm. You can save cash and be better protected from mayhem. Like me.
Shop less, get more. Make one call to an Allstate agent.
So how do we feel?
Like we're finally ready for that trip to Spain. Eh, muchacho?
Yeah.
Get in, get confident. Supercuts every time.
Tony, pick it up.
You know, I'm just not feeling the wood-cutting thing today.
Tony, eat a Snickers.
Why?
Because you get a little bit whiny when you're hungry.
Better?
Better.
You're not you when you're hungry.
Hey! My back hurts!
Snickers satisfies.
Now my friend hurts.
Many will hear the calling.
Move it!
Yes, sir!
Few will earn the title United States Marine. The few, the proud Marines.
Critics everywhere are cheering for Tintin. LA Times raves, it's a whole lot of fun. 4 stars, 2 thumbs up. Steven Spielberg and Peter Jackson have created pure magic.
Well done, Snowy.
The Adventures of Tintin in real D, 3D, and IMAX 3D, rated PG.
Saturday, college football returns to the City by the Bay. The Fighting Illini battle the Bruins in the second annual Kraft Fight Hunger Bowl.
Hello, end zone.
Kraft Foods and its iconic brands such as Oreo, Kraft Singles, Maxwell House, Kraft Mac and Cheese, and Oscar Mayer are proud sponsors of the Kraft Fight Hunger Bowl.
Into the clear! Touchdown, UCLA!
Illinois versus UCLA, Saturday at 3:30 Eastern on ESPN.
Happy holidays from Ford Field and the Little Caesars Bowl. As Capital One Bowl Week continues, 24 bowl games remaining. And an 8-7 lead as we start the second quarter. And Siller is back on the Wildcat. Turbush, the quarterback, lines up as the wideout to the bottom of the screen. Siller will keep it. The Detroit native across midfield, bursting into the secondary, inside the 35. And then a flag at the end of the play will tack on even more. Paul Hazel with a horse collar, a 24-yard pickup, and they'll add to it.
And Turbush, once again, at the point of attack. I don't really think that they plan it that way, but Siller with the Wildcat made the read, did a nice job. After the play, personal foul. Late hit out of bounds. Number 99, defense. 15-yard penalty, automatic, first down. Siller's going to tell Turbush, if you blocked your guy, I might have scored. Right here. That's him behind. And then he'd sort of get out of the way. You see 19 in the corner of the screen there. Then you see the late throw him down that caused the penalty. It's a little bit too much. Once you step out of bounds, you got to lay off.
Turbush is wide receiver again. This time he'll go to the top of the screen. Siller still at quarterback. Akeem Hunt is offset. Hunt will get the carry, and a lot of white jerseys around. Hunt able to get inside the 15. Let's send it down to Eamon.
Beth, in between quarters, Coach Hope walked over to find his place kicker, Carson Wiggs. I couldn't hear what the head coach said, but they both started laughing and smiling. And as the head coach walked away, Carson Wiggs told his teammates, all I know is I didn't think that thing was going to go 4 yards when he was talking about the onside kick. But obviously on the Boilermaker sideline, they can laugh about it now.
It has set them up for this drive right here. They're now inside the red zone. It was one of the longest in terms of time onside kicks. It took a while to get that 10 yards. Oh, it's loose. And the Broncos have their second turnover with Purdue driving.
I was just going to say that Purdue is doing a great job of taking Drew Nowak out of the game because they're running laterally. But unfortunately, he didn't need to be involved in that play to get the turnover.
Lakeem Hunt, the true freshman, just the second fumble for a running back all year for Purdue.
You felt like this before, right? 2:30 in the afternoon, a lot to do, and you've hit the wall. But you gotta get stuff done. So take 5-Hour Energy. Just open it up, knock it back, and roll up your sleeves. 5-Hour Energy is faster and easier than coffee. Man, does it work. You'll get that alert, energized feeling you need to get stuff done. A lot of stuff. Wow, look at you go. 5-Hour Energy, when you gotta get stuff done.
If you subscribe to the crazy notion that the financial goals of a lifetime deserve more than a 10-minute chat.
If you have the nerve to believe your call is important to us, should actually be the truth.
If you believe your financial advisor should listen as much as he speaks.
Join the nearly 7 million investors who think like you do. FaceTime and ThinkTime make a difference.
Join us.
At Edward Jones, it's how we make sense of investing.
The Big East and ACC champs look to light up South Florida in primetime.
And he got it! Touchdown!
The 2012 Discover Orange Bowl. West Virginia Clemson. Coverage begins January 4th at 8 on ESPN.
If you had a choice between going bald and a full head of hair, which would you choose? Advances in medical science have resulted in the world's first and only permanent solution to hair loss.
Yes!
You wash it, you cut it. It's your own real naturally growing hair. When it comes to hair restoration, no one in the world has more experience than Bosley. The results look completely natural and are affordable on nearly any budget. But the entire process can't be explained in 60 brief seconds. So to find out more about this clinically proven and permanent solution to hair loss, call now to receive your free no obligation information kit. It'll answer all of your questions about hair loss and hair restoration. Plus, we'll also send you this $250 gift certificate just for calling. Every day you wait, you're losing more hair. So don't put it off any longer. You owe it to yourself to find out the facts. Choose hair. Choose Bosley.
Call 1-800-205-0513. That's 1-800-205-0513.
Limits inspire the limitless. Levi LaValle, redefining redemption. Robbie Madison, flying 400 feet. Red Bull, new year, no limits.
Well, Mitch Zajac with the strip of the freshman Akeem Hunt. A couple of turnovers here for Western Michigan. They wanted a good start today. They got it. They wanted to force turnovers. They've done that as well, seeking their first bowl win in school history. Carter with the give to Scriven. He gets the edge across the 20. And a first down out to the 26. Let's go back to the nice play by Zajac to knock this one loose.
One of the things that usually happens at the end of a play when a back tries to extend and get more yardage, he's less likely to be able to protect that ball. Just happened right there. Zajac, great job of ripping it from his grasp, but not two hands on the ball. Got to cover it up all the way to the end of the play.
Zajac playing in his 50th career game today to tie the school record, as well as the kicker and the punter, John Potter and Ben Armour. And more first down yardage for Western Michigan. They only had the ball for 2 minutes and 8 seconds in that first quarter.
Nice job of trickeration there. They brought the backs back into the backfield. 29 is their leading rusher, Devin Drake. He's the guy who usually carries the ball, but Carter kept it. Huge gaping hole inside.
15-yard pickup behind Millie Utalia and Kevin Gallagher. They'll set up the screen. Fields may have picked up one. Second down and about eight. He and statistics, well, they don't tell the story about what's on the scoreboard right now, and a one-point lead for Western Michigan.
It just goes, sure, they don't mean very much. Yeah, you're the only one that counts is the points on the scoreboard. Remember that. Remember that.
Jordan White, a 49-yard touchdown catch, and then a two-point conversion on a fake PAT. An interception. They were trying to throw it across the middle to Jordan White.
Gerald Gooden dropped into coverage underneath. He looked like the rush. Stepped back in the middle to act like to cut off the crossers. Quarterback did not see him and dumped it right into his lap.
The fifth-year senior from Hooks, Texas, with his first pick of the year.
Watch him. See him right there. He's just lurking. He just drops back. He comes off the edge and backs into the middle of the field like a zone blitz type concept. He becomes a linebacker going to look for the crossers.
And what a moment for Gooden. He's had a rough week. Both he and Will Lucas, two of their starting defenders, were arrested last week. Not charged in an off-field incident that was handled internally. Edison hauled down behind the line of scrimmage by Johnny Simon. We'll lose a few on the play.
And we talked about all the people that carry the ball for Purdue. Davian Edison, Pegram, Shavers, Crank, Akeem Hunt. It really doesn't matter. They do a lot of the same things, but they also have people that, this is my play. I do these certain things. This Crank, for example, is a power back and probably the best pass protector. So he's going to run power plays and be part of their pass protection package.
Bolden was having a good year before the ACL, but it's been a bit of running by committee all season for the Boilermakers. Turbush will keep, takes a stick at the 36-yard line by Simon, and Turbush pops right back up.
Johnny Simon, that was a form tackle, and he's one of the best athletes. He plays there, what we call a Sam or strong side linebacker. They call it Rover. He always goes to the tight end usually and plays off. He's their force guy on that side of the field.
Simon, the sophomore from West Palm Beach, the majority of their starters, the linebackers and secondary, Florida guys. One of their top recruiters in Florida is actually Bill Cubitt's son, Ryan, who is the quarterback's coach. Turbush. 41-yard line to Gary Bush.
They're just trying to now to find single coverage, find the off coverage. They had a bunch set into the boundary, had two receivers out to the wide side of the field. And when you get that, that's a lot of area to cover for a defensive back. They'll tend to play a little softer. They took advantage of that, didn't quite get the yards they needed.
Carson Wiggs missed a 45-yarder at the other end of the field, and now a 49-yard attempt. He's got five over 50 yards on his career. Had made nine in a row before that last miss, and true on this one as the Boilermakers grab the lead 10-8 with 10:34 to go in the first half here at the Little Caesars Bowl. It's the Big Ten versus the MAC.
You want to score a deal on dinner? Then listen up, because this play is money. Everybody, cut right to your computer or cell phone. Hit LittleCaesars.com, download the coupon, buy any hot and ready pizza, and you'll get a free 8-piece order of Crazy Bread. Buy any pizza and get free Crazy Bread. This place is going wild, but it's good for 3 days only, so the clock is running. Get to Little Caesars with your coupon and seal the deal tonight.
Pizza, pizza.
Tony, pick it up.
You know, I'm just not feeling the woodcutting thing today.
Tony, eat a Snickers.
Why?
Because you eat a little bit whiny when you're hungry.
Better?
Better.
You're not you when you're hungry.
Hey! My back hurts.
Snickers satisfies.
Now my front hurts.
As my world turns, the heart beats. Not only in my chest, but the heart in the streets. So when they feel this, they feel me. But I can't feel nothing outside these great beats. I am from the city of people, came from the bottom.
Yo. I'm on my way.
Experience your sound like never before. The HTC Resound with Beats Audio built in. Let the pros at Best Buy hook you up today.
It's a 403 horsepower, 6.2 liter V8. Nutcracker. The 2011 GMC Sierra.
Now during the GMC holiday event, get 0% financing for 72 months, plus 500 bonus cash on Sierra, plus 1 year of SiriusXM satellite radio, including every NFL game. Hurry, our best offer of the year ends January 3rd.
I didn't know AutoTrader.com had new cars, but what kind of deal can I get?
On AutoTrader.com, you can now compare brand spanking new cars and special offers.
That one.
So you can find the one new car your head and heart can agree on.
Whoa.
AutoTrader.com.
College football, the Little Caesars Bowl, is brought to you by the GMC Sierra. Now during the GMC holiday event, trade up to the best Sierra ever and get some of the best offers of the year. Travelers, insurance for auto, home, and business. And UAW, Chrysler, Ford, and General Motors.
.10:34 to go here in the first half. All 18 points scored off of turnovers today. And Purdue with the 10-8 lead over Western Michigan. Carson Wiggs with the kickoff. Devon Wallace out across the 25. Let's send it down to John Saunders for a Sports Center right now.
Well, thanks a lot. And the Pittsburgh Steelers coach Mike Tomlin is saying, and I quote, that Ben Roethlisberger has a shot at playing against Cleveland in the season ender with that high ankle sprain he missed last week. Rick Pitino, head coach at Louisville, says he's not going to coach after his current contract expires. Of course, that expires in 2017. Back to you.
Of course, Ben Roethlisberger, a good MAC quarterback from the past. And hey, how about the notable alum for Western Michigan? Our very own John Saunders spent some time in Kazoo. They are carrying the flag for the MAC of their bowl teams, the only crack at a BCS opponent. The MAC, by the way, starting out 2-0 this bowl season. Picked up wins Temple and Ohio. Toledo will be in action in the Military Bowl, presented by Northrop Grumman. Northern Illinois will be playing in the GoDaddy.com Bowl. Well, they've got a couple more teams in action.
When you're a non-AQ conference, you have that chip on your shoulder we talked about in the pregame. You want to go get it. Get a little respect for your conference.
Their motto the last few weeks is chasing history, trying to secure the first bowl win in school history. Carter finding his favorite target, Jordan Wright, the second team All-American who led the country this year in catches and receiving yards.
Thing about White is he's adept at reading zone or man-to-man. He's separate. He knows where the holes are in his zone. He can defeat man coverage because he's so physical and quick enough and strong enough to separate.
18 yards to White. He's got their touchdown, a 49-yard catch. A couple of catches today, 67 yards. Fields, he runs right into Joe Holland in the absence of Dwayne Beckford, who's been suspended. Joe Holland takes over as the top tackler on this defensive unit.
You know, we might talk about this is a Western Michigan is a wristband team. They got wristbands that tell them what the plays are, so they just get a signal from the sideline that tells them which play on the wristband, except that when the quarterback has to audible, then he's got to overrule everybody, say, hey, wait, time out, guys, I got another play. So it's interesting, watch this.
Showing the five wideouts again. A move that they made, by the way, midway through the season. So they have not even been running this style of offense the entire year.
No, but what a great fit it is. What a nice job of knowing where the sticks are. We talk about getting the sticks for the first down yardage. Manette does a great job of there just finding, settling down there. You can see the signal. That tells you blank four. It might be neck four, whichever side it is, on the thing. And everybody looks at that. They've all got them. They all know what the play is.
They had to switch to this offense after several running backs got hurt. It's worked well, especially for this guy, Jordan Wright, inside the 25. And the Broncos moving it with ease. 22-yard pickup, White's third catch.
And we talked about Carter's comfort zone with knowing where receivers are going to be, know the timing. You read a certain progression of this guy to this guy to this guy, and White usually finds a way to get open.
White is a student of the game. One of his favorites to study is another former Bronco standout, Greg Jennings, with the Green Bay Packers. has really helped Jordan work on the mental game. And Jordan says he watches a ton of film to prep. He's the short man across the middle. He'll try to go net deeper and complete.